Praise be to Jesus. Today's Gospel and Reflection. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 20, verses 27 to 14. Jesus replied, "Men and women marry because they belong to this world. But for those who are considered worthy of the world to come and of resurrection from the dead, there is no more marriage. You must know that they are like angels and cannot die anymore. They are now children of God because God has raised them from the dead. Yes, the dead will be raised, and even Moses showed it to be true in the passage about the burning bush, where he calls the Lord the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. For he is God of the living and not of the dead. For to him all are alive." Today, the Church celebrates the presentation of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The Gospel passage speaks of the encounter between Jesus and the Sadducees. As we know, they only accepted the Torah and did not give any importance to the book of the New Testament. This is for the first time they face Jesus in this Gospel of St. Luke to trap him. Jesus exposes their stupidity concerning the way of life in the present world and the next world. This episode forcefully affirms the belief in the resurrection and articulates the quality of risen life. Jesus teaches that struggles and trials of this world are rewarded in heaven. The existence of heaven is made very clear. Our God is a God of the living and not of the dead. Each one is rewarded based on the life lived on this earth. It is a continuation of this earthly life. In other words, it is an invitation to live with the God of the living. The Feast of Presentation of our Heavenly Mother highlights the holiness of Mary from the beginning of her life on earth and continued through her early childhood and beyond. Blessed Mother lived a holy life on this earth. She is known as the most prudent, most pure, most humble, most faithful, most obedient, and most merciful. She radiated joy and peace to everyone she encountered. Every action performed for those around her was done out of love for the Lord. Our mother was able to confidently give her fiat at the moment of the Annunciation and also in every circumstance after that. Her entire life was a prayer, constantly placing herself in the presence of the Lord. She was able to see the beauty of seeking God's will in every moment. She did not run to others first, but always conversed with the Lord first, so that she could embrace God's will at each and every moment of her life. Mary gave her fiat, her yes, to Christ. Mary's patience culminated at the foot of her son's cross, where she truly became a martyr through her patient and complete suffering in union with her own son. She saw herself as God saw her, nothing more or nothing less. She died to herself from the moment she said, "Not my will, but yours be done." She continued through her entire life living these virtues. Blessed Mother is right there with us at our every step. Let us love her and call her, asking for her guidance and assistance to live our earthly lives as the Lord wants from us, so that we will be able to enjoy a blissful life in heaven with the God of the living and not of the dead. Amen.